Hello guys, and welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In the last video, we have talked about the prokaryotic cell. The overview of prokaryotic cell, ki uske andar kya kya present hota hai, what are the different kind of structures that are present inside prokaryotic cell, what is mesosome. In this video, we are going to talk specifically about the cell envelope of the prokaryotic cell and its modifications also. Okay, so what is cell envelope? And what are the different modifications of cell envelope in case of prokaryotic cell, uske baare mein hum baat karenge. So what we have read till now, we have read about the overview of cell as well as specifically about the prokaryotic cell. Now in prokaryotic cell also, we are going to take out one and one organelles and we are going to take an overview of them as well, ki har organelle ke andar kya hota hai. So sabse pehle hum baat karenge yaar cell envelope ki, which is the most important part. What is the function of cell envelope? Cell envelope is formed up of three different layers which are tightly packed, and all these three layers are having distinct functions. But in spite of those distinct functions and distinct nature also, they are having a common function, that is of protection, and that's why it is known as envelope. Okay? आप जब कोई parcel भेजते हो कहीं दूर तो envelope में डाल के भेजा जाता है, उसके ऊपर tape वेप लगाई जाती है जिससे कि वो parcel को कोई harm ना हो. Similarly, the cell is also having some sort of envelope around it, a cover around it, which is obviously meant for protection. So let's consider that this is a cell, okay? This is the huge cell. I'm just taking a boundary of it because we are going to talk about the cell envelope only. तो उसी की बात की जाए तो अच्छा है, क्योंकि पूरा cell हम पढ़ चुके हैं. So यहाँ पर there are three different layers as I have told, which are tightly packed. In some of the cases they are loosely packed also, but in most of the cases they are tightly packed, okay? Because they are quite compact structures. The one layer is arranged in such a way that it is contacting with the other layer, right? So the innermost thing is the plasma membrane or the cell membrane. Okay, let's talk about it. Okay, plasma membrane ke baare mein thodi si baat yahi pe kar lete hain so that we can get a better view when we are going to talk about it in detail. So what is plasma membrane? Plasma membrane is basically the limiting structure or delimiting structure in case of mammalian cells or animal cell, because animal cell do not contain the cell wall. They just have an outer membrane that is called as the plasma membrane or the cell membrane. They do not have cell wall. So it is the most outer membrane in case of animal cell. But in case of plant cells or in the cells of lower organisms, the cell wall is also present. Okay. So plasma membrane basically kya hoti hai? It is a lipid bilayer which is embedded with proteins. So let's say these are the polar head groups. Okay, lipid bilayer is having two layer, and I'm just showing you one layer over here. Okay, each layer has some polar head groups and these tails. So this is the one layer. Now if we have to form the bilayer, we need to form the same structure below as well. Okay, now this is the lipid bilayer. There are some different kind of proteins which are also present over here. For example, intrinsic protein. Intrinsic protein means they are embedded in the membrane itself. So let me make this protein over here. Yeah, right. So this is intrinsic protein because this is already embedded in the plasma membrane. So it is intrinsic. Now there are some peripheral proteins or extrinsic protein. Let's say this one. Okay, this is present outside the lipid bilayer. So it is peripheral protein or the extrinsic protein because it is present outside. Okay, so intrinsic means inside, extrinsic means outside. There are some transmembrane protein. Okay, transmembrane means crossing the membrane. So there are the huge proteins such like that. If this is the membrane, okay, so they are present all the way between the membrane. Because let's say the water or any kind of hydrophilic thing, okay, which is dissolved in water, have to cross the plasma membrane, then it cannot cross the plasma membrane directly. Okay, because this is the polar head group over here and these are the lipid molecules. The lipid and water molecules have different nature. Lipid is hydrophobic and water is hydrophilic. So water is hydrophilic, obviously it is water. So water and water soluble compounds cannot directly cross the membrane. Okay, because lipid will not let the water soluble molecules to penetrate through the membrane because it will repel it. But if there is some water or water soluble molecules, this protein, or we can say this transmembrane protein or channel, will let it to cross the plasma membrane from both the sides. Okay, so these are known as transmembrane proteins or some sort of channel proteins. Okay, so ये क्या होते हैं? Channel की तरह काम करते हैं. ये channel एक आयन को ट्रांसफर करने में मदद करते हैं या फिर किसी भी पर्टिकुलर चीज को ट्रांसफर करने में मदद करते हैं जो कि वाटर सॉल्युबल है. बिकॉज इफ समथिंग इज लिपिड सॉल्युबल, ओके लेट्स से दिस इज द लिपिड सॉल्युबल पार्टिकल, ओके लिपिड सॉल्युबल पार्टिकल, देन कैन क्रॉस डायरेक्टली द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. इट डू नॉट रिक्वायर एनी काइंड ऑफ ट्रांस मेम्ब्रेन थिंग बिकॉज लिपिड एंड लिपिड आर लाइक, सो इट विल श्योरली पास द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन विदाउट द नीड ऑफ एनी कैरियर प्रोटीन और एनी काइंड ऑफ ट्रांस मेम्ब्रेन चैनल, राइट? सो दीज आर सेमी परमिएबल थिंग्स. ओके, दे डू नॉट लेट ईच एंड एवरी थिंग टू पास थ्रू द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन ओनली गिव दिस परमिशन टू सिलेक्टेड मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड ओनली दो सिलेक्टेड मॉलिक्यूल्स कैन पास थ्रू द यू नो मेम्ब्रेन. सो दिस इज अबाउट द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन और सेल मेम्ब्रेन. डिटेल में बात मैं ऑलरेडी कर चुका हूँ, दो वीडियोज आई हैव ऑलरेडी मेड देम अर्लियर, सो यू कैन वॉच इट डाउन. आफ्टर दैट सेल वॉल, सो द इनसाइड लेयर वॉज प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन, देन सेल वॉल. सेल वॉल वी हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट in the last lecture that there are different kind of cell wall in different organisms. When we talk about archaebacteria, then in archaebacteria it is formed up of pseudomurine. Okay, let me write it over here. Pseudomurine. In case of bacteria or eubacteria, it is formed up of peptidoglycan. Okay, the peptidoglycan is a polymer of NAM plus NAG. NAG is N-acetyl glucosamine and NAM is N-acetyl muriamic acid. So N-acetyl muriamic acid and N-acetyl glucosamine ka jo monomer hota hai, that will repeat itself to form a very huge chain, a very huge polymer that is known as the peptidoglycan. After that, if we will talk about fungus, then the fungi will have a cell wall of chitin. Okay, the chitin. Chitinous cell wall is present in fungus. When we talk about plant, they are also having cell wall which is cellulosic in nature. So there are different kind of organisms, different kind of diversity, and all of them are having different type of cell wall as well. The material which is forming the cell wall is very different. Okay, so the diversity of cell wall is quite huge, and it is a kind of protective structure. Hum jante hain. So it will not let a particular plant cell or any kind of cell to easily burst. Okay, ये जो है किसी भी चीज को आसानी से burst होने नहीं देती. Okay, so cell wall और plasma membrane हो चुके हैं. So the innermost layer is plasma membrane. We know it is the inner layer. After that, the cell wall is present. Okay, in case of plant cell also we have discussed this thing. But in case of cell envelope, there is third layer which is glycocalyx. Okay, now this is very important. What is glycocalyx and why it is known as glycocalyx? Glyco simply means sugars, okay? And the bonding that is made by sugars is also known as the glycosidic bond. That's why the glyco is taken from sugar. Glycocalyx has different components. For example, glycolipid and glycoprotein. Now, as I have said, glyco means sugar. So when this sugar or carbohydrate moieties attach or interact with the lipid, they are forming glycolipid. And when those carbohydrate or sugar moieties are interacting with protein, they are forming glycoprotein. So that glycolipid and glycoprotein pool will be present outside the cell wall. Okay, ये जो cell wall है, इसके बाहर glycoprotein और glycolipid का pool present होगा एक, which is also known as the pericellular. Okay, pericellular matrix. Peri means at the periphery, it means that the outer thing. Cellular simply means outside the cell, and it is a kind of matrix. Okay, so pericellular matrix bhi kaha jata hai glycocalyx ko, which is formed up of glycoproteins and glycolipids. Now, what is the function of glycocalyx? We have talked about the selectively permeable nature of plasma membrane. We have talked about the cell wall, that it is providing protection as well as it will not let the cell burst. But what is the function of glycocalyx? The glycocalyx helps a lot in recognition. When you are going through a very important chapter, that is immunology, then you will know the importance of these things, that how much they are important in cell-cell recognition. Okay? कोई भी चीज अगर हमारी बॉडी में आई है, उसको रिकॉग्नाइज करने का जो काम है, हर सेल में कुछ ना कुछ अलग बातें होती हैं, और ये चीजें सिग्नल को लेने में भी काम करती है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, देर आर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ रिसेप्टर्स ऑन आवर बॉडी एज वेल. ओके, So if there is a cell and that cell is having receptor for a particular hormone, how does the hormone work? This is a gland. Let's say this is hypothalamus. It is secreting some kind of hormone. And we know that hormones do not travel through ducts. Okay? Because endocrine glands are ductless glands. Unme ducts hote hi nahi hai. There is no tube. The hormones are directly secreted in the blood and the blood flow will take the hormone to each and every part of the body. But let's say there is a hormone called X. And my pancreas require that hormone X, which is secreted by the brain. So my pancreas has given a signal to brain to secrete X, which must be given to the pancreas. But the brain will secrete that hormone in the blood flow. That hormone should be going to liver also, that hormone should be going to stomach also, that should be going to heart also. How does that hormone will recognize ki bhai pancreas pe hi jana hai? Kuch to hoga pancreas mein aisa. The pancreatic cells have the receptors for that particular hormone, and that receptor are proteinaceous in nature, which are interacted with the membrane. Okay, each cell has some membrane, and on that membrane there is some receptor, okay, which is interacting with the membrane. That receptor is totally exposed. Okay, in some cases the receptor are present inside the cell if the hormone is, you know, lipid soluble, because lipid soluble hormone can directly enter inside the cell, so it can interact with the intracellular receptor. But if the hormone is water soluble, it cannot enter into the cell. So kya hoga, the receptor will be present. Okay, this is the cell membrane or cell wall. The receptor will be present on the surface. This is the hormone X. The X hormone, when come through the bloodstream, it is recognized by the receptor. Haan bhai main aa gaya. Aur ab andar jo hai chemical reactions start ho jayengi. Jo mujhe chahiye tha wo mujhe mil jayega. So this kind of recognition, okay, I'm just telling you an example that how the things are recognized in body. This is not that easier. It is a very complex pathway. When you will go deep into the immunology thing, you will find it very interesting, as well as, you know, ki hamari body mein yaar ye sab hota hai. Bahut hi zyada complex cheeze hain, bahut hi complex cycles hain, but it is quite interesting as well. So is tarike se kafi sari cheeze hoti hain. That kind of recognition or that kind of interaction is mediated by the glycocalyx in most of the prokaryotes. Okay, so we have learned about the glycocalyx till now. Okay, hum kya padh chuke hain? Glycocalyx padh chuke hain, plasma membrane and cell wall, and these three layers are formed compactly present to form the cell envelope, and they have a combined function of protection. Alag alag function to inke humne padh liye, lekin jo combined function hai, that is in protection. If they are a little bit loosely bound, then it is known as the slime layer. So this is also very important. These two things are very very essential from examination point of view. Kafi baar puchhi ja chuki hain. If the cell envelope is not that tightly bound, it is known as the slime layer. But when it is very tightly aggregated, it is known as the capsule. Okay? Kisi bhi cheez ko bahut hi kadak tarike se agar ye bandh lete hain yaar, to use bolte hain hum capsule. So slime layer and capsule are the same thing, but the interaction is different. Okay, slime layer is a little bit more loose as compared to that of capsule, but both of these are exactly same things. In both of the things we are talking about the cell envelope, lekin wo cell envelope kis condition mein present hai wo different hai yaar. Okay, so is tarike se slime layer kya hogi, thodi si loose hogi, capsule is very compact. This is about the cell envelope. Uske baad prokaryotes mein kafi alag alag cheeze bhi present hoti hain. The cell envelope itself shows different kind of thing, different patterns, okay, different composition. अलग अलग जो बैक्टीरिया है या फिर अलग अलग हम कह सकते हैं जो प्रोकैरियोट्स हैं, उनमें इस जो ये है हमारा सेल एनवेलप, इसकी कॉम्पोजिशन डिफरेंट हो सकती है. एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट कॉम्पोजिशन द सेल कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू टू डिफरेंट थिंग्स, दैट इज ग्राम पॉजिटिव एंड ग्राम नेगेटिव. And it is also dependent on a thing, that whether they are going to take the gram stain or not. There is a stain, okay? उस gram stain को अगर कोई चीज पकड़ के रखती है, कोई cell पकड़ के रखता है, then it is gram positive. Positive because it is retaining the stain. But it is gram negative if it is not retaining the stain. There is a procedure of gram staining things, okay? The iodine is also used. There are different kind of things which are used. Safranine, there is crystal violet. लेकिन यहाँ पर हमें क्या याद रखना है? If you have applied the stain to a cell and you have washed it, then it will surely remove the stain. Okay, if the stain is removed, it is not retaining the stain properly, then it is gram negative. Negative means it is not retaining the stain at all. But gram positive in the sense if it retains the stain. Okay, so it depends upon the composition of this cell envelope. The cell envelope composition differs in different prokaryotes. Okay, some of these are having an external layer, an extra layer, and some of these will not have that. So uske basis par kya hai, kuch cell gram stain ko retain kar pate hai, kuch cell gram stain ko retain nahi kar pate. We will also talk about the gram staining procedure. Abhi ho sakta hai, if you are not knowing the gram staining procedure very well, then it will create some sort of confusion ki yaar positive kya hai, negative kya hai. But after knowing the protocol or the procedure, you will be easily knowing ki haan bhai gram negative positive kya hai. So we are not talking about that in detail because I am going to make next lecture a separate video on this gram negative or gram positive thing. Okay? So is tarike ka behavior bhi jo hai cell envelope ki wajah se show hota hai. Now let's talk about the mesosomes. In last lecture humne baat ki thi, there are infoldings or intrusions of plasma membrane which are formed that are known as mesosomes. Okay? And that mesosome have a variety of function. For example, the mesosome can help in the cell wall formation because it is in the form of vesicles. Okay, what are vesicles? These are the membrane bound rounded structure which will carry the protein inside it and which will carry the membrane itself. Since it is a membrane, so jahan par is membrane ki requirement hogi, wherever this membrane is required, it will fuse with that surface. For example, this is the cell wall, okay, and it need to be this much long, but it is quite short now. The cell is growing in size, so the cell wall must also grow in size to accumulate all the internal things, right? For that, the cell wall need to be synthesized. So this vesicle will come and fuse to this plasma, cell wall, and the membrane present over here will be increasing the size of cell wall. Okay, इस तरीके से क्या रहता है? Membrane जो है एक जगह से दूसरी जगह transfer हो जाते हैं. This is known as the membranor or vesicular transport. Okay, so the plasma membrane can also be synthesized by the same thing, and it also mediates some sort of reactions, जो कि आपके लिए अभी समझना थोड़ा सा मुश्किल हो जाएगा. So आप बस इतना याद कर लीजिए that it helps in wall formation. Okay, then in the replication of DNA as well as its transport. So जो DNA replication होता है और उसका जब transport होता है उसमें भी हमें जरूरत पड़ती है mesosomes की, and it also increases the surface area. अब I have two different cases. One is this. Okay, the surface area is quite less. And the second one is this. The surface area increased up to several folds. So much more is the surface area, more respiration can take place, more ATP can be generated. So respiration may be, or energy development may be, or we can say that much more is the surface area, more will be the enzymatic activity. So enzymatic reactions, respiration, ATP production, all of these things increases just because of increase in the surface area. That's why the mesosome is very important. So it helps in the cell wall formation, it helps in the DNA replication of a prokaryote, it helps in the, you know, translocation of that replicated thing, and after that it also helps in the respiration process or in the enzymatic reactions. Okay, this mesosome can be formed in the form of vesicles, in the form of tubules, or in the form of lamellae. Okay, lamellae are the elongated structures which are itself intrusions, just like the mesosomes. Then tubule are longer structures, just like a tube. And vesicle, as I have told, are the round membrane bound things, okay, which will carry some protein or the thing that is need to be transferred from one place to the other place inside a cell. So, एक सेल में ट्रांसपोर्ट करने के लिए वेसाइकल क्या करेगी? मेम्ब्रेन तो इसके चारों ओर होगी ही, लेकिन इसके अंदर ही कुछ सामान भी लेके जाती है. गाड़ी खाली नहीं जा रही, इसके अंदर जो है कुछ सामान हमेशा फिल्ड है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, मैंने कल आपको बताया था कि यहाँ पर अगर न्यूक्लियस है, न्यूक्लियस के पास देयर इज एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम एंड देयर इज गॉल्जी. सो द प्रोटीन्स विच आर फॉर्म्ड बाय द RER आर ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द गोल्जी फॉर प्रोसेसिंग प्रोसेस. ओके, प्रोसेसिंग होती है गोल्जी में भी. So, उस कॉम्प्लेक्स प्रोसेसिंग रिएक्शन के लिए प्रोटीन्स को भेजा जाता है फ्रॉम ER टू GC, एंड दैट ऑल्सो टुक प्लेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ वेसाइकल. द प्रोटीन्स आर कोटेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वेसाइकल एंड दे यूज टू फ्यूज विद दिस गोल्जी एंड दे सेंड द प्रोटीन इनसाइड गोल्जी फॉर द प्रोसेसिंग. ओके, इस तरीके से क्या रहता है? ट्रांसपोर्ट होता है. So the mesosome can be in the form of vesicle, tubules or lamellae. This is very important. And after that, there are some specific functions such as DNA replication, its transport, respiration, enzymatic reactions and the cell wall formation. In case of cyanobacteria, there are other things like that. For example, mesosome is not an organelle. It is just an enfolding of plasma membrane. Similarly, in cyanobacteria also some things are present called as chromatophores, and chroma simply means color. Okay, so these are the colored bodies. So chromatophore are some sort of colored bodies which are present in the cyanobacteria. Ho sakta hai question aa jaye ki what is the extra structure that is present in cyanobacteria jo ki specific hota hai uske liye, that is chromatophores. So you don't have to understand anything, just chroma means color. So it will, you know, help you a lot ki ha yaar iska matlab kya hai, to iska function kya hoga, us hisab se aap log naam se hi answer nikal sakte hain. Then there are some other things in cell. अगर प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल की बात करें तो यार वो मूव भी करते हैं. अब हाथ पैर तो उनके होते नहीं है तो मूव कैसे करते हैं? देयर आर सम एक्स्ट्रा थिंग्स सच एज फ्लैजेला, फिम्ब्रे, पिलाई, सिलिया, ऑल दोस थिंग्स. सो फ्लैजेला इज द मोस्ट प्रोमिनेंट थिंग दैट इज इन्वॉल्वड इन द मूवमेंट. ओके, फॉर मूवमेंट फ्लैजेला इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. सो इट हैज थ्री डिफरेंट पार्ट्स. द फर्स्ट वन इज, लेट्स से दिस इज द सेल वॉल. So it does not come from the plasma membrane, it used to come from the cell wall. So this is very important thing. Mesosome is the intrusion or the enfolding of plasma membrane, but flagella comes from cell wall. So aapko ye bhi cheez yaad rakhni hai. The first thing is the basal body, which is attached just like this to hold the thing inside a cell wall. After that there is a hook, and after that there is a filament which is the longer and the largest portion, just like this. So the flagella is present on a cell, which is a very huge thing. Okay, so there will be basal body which is present at the base, as the name indicates. Then there will be a hook which is for the attachment, and after that there is a filament which is quite long structure which will flap like this. Okay, the movement will provide the movement to cell as well. Okay, so filament hai hamare paas hook hai, hamare paas basal body hai. This is the flagella which is attached to the cell wall which provides movement. After that, pili are some sort of tubular structures which are also present in some of the prokaryotes, not in all. And after that, fimbriae are also some things jo ki present hoti hain cell ke surface pe bahut zyada amount mein, because these fimbriae used to provide the attachment or encouragement to a particular substratum. If the bacteria need to attach itself to a tissue, okay, and this is the tissue surface, so it need grip for that. Okay, agar yaar hame kisi cheez pe chadhna hai, अगर हमें किसी सीढ़ी पे चढ़ना है तो हम अपने हाथों पे तेल लगा के नहीं चढ़ सकते क्योंकि हम गिर जाएंगे, बिकॉज यू नीड ग्रिप. सो फॉर दैट हम क्या करेंगे, उसको बहुत टाइटली पकड़ने की कोशिश करेंगे, या तो हम ग्लव्स पहन के चढ़ेंगे जिससे कि हमारी ग्रिप बन सके. ओके, हम फिर यार ऐसा कुछ नहीं है ऑयल लगाएंगे या फिर पानी वानी गिरा हो उस पर पहले से वैसे चढ़ेंगे, हम सीढ़ी को साफ करके चढ़ेंगे जिससे कि अटैचमेंट के लिए हमें बहुत ही ज्यादा सही जगह मिले जो कि फिसले नहीं. उसी तरीके से देयर आर फिम्ब्रे विच आर प्रेजेंट ऑन द surfaces of this cell, and that will provide the power of encouragement or attachment to the substratum or the surface wherever it want to get itself attached. Okay, so ye tha yaar lecture. Humne kya kya padha? Humne padha cell envelope. Cell envelope mein humne baat ki about the cell wall, the plasma membrane and the glycocalyx. The, you know, same procedure that they have to perform, the same function that they have to perform is protection, but they have different functions as well. After that, we have talked about the mesosome, its function, and it is formed up of vesicle, tubules, and lamellae. Anything. उसके बाद gram positive, gram negative. हो सकता है इस chapter के बाद मैं इस पर एक video बनाऊँ जो कि मैं for sure बनाऊंगा. This is quite important because some students always have some confusion कि यार gram positive, negative होता क्या है. 11th pass कर लेते हैं, 12th pass कर लेते हैं, pre medical भी निकल जाता है, पर इस procedure के बारे में detail में नहीं पता होता. So I'm going to tell you the protocol that what is the gram staining procedure. After that, we have talked about the flagella, fimbriae, pili, which are the surface things that are, you know, present on a prokaryotic cell. So this is about the prokaryotic cell. We are going to talk about the remaining organelles of a prokaryotic cell, and after that we will move toward the eukaryotic cell, the complex plant and animal cell. उनकी फिर एक-एक organelle निकाल के हम उनके बारे में बात करेंगे in detail. So I hope that you are liking this lecture series a lot. अगर आप लोगों को पसंद आई, then do hit like button, share this video with your friends. Subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for sure. Thank you so much.